and can I pay tribute to the members of the Stolen Generations for your incredible resilience, stoicism and dignity in the face of untold suffering. Let your healing begin and let the healing of the nation begin. Thank you.
Now, in 2008, you were asked to deliver the formal response to the national apology to the Stolen Generations on behalf of the Stolen Generations representative bodies. Can you tell us how you felt when you made that speech and what the atmosphere was like in the room?
I'd been involved pre the apology. The minister had, Jenny Macklin at the time, had invited me to pull together the Stolen Generations Alliance and the National Sorry Day Committee to work out if the Prime Minister was to give an apology, what should be included in it, how should we celebrate it, etc. So we were involved in that process, and as those groups had then asked me if I could respond formally. And so then having to say, OK, I've got to respond on behalf of all these people, you know, and the Stolen Generations and their descendants are all experiencing this. But it was, one of the biggest privileges I've had, in being invited to do that by our mob.
It's been 5 years since the Uluru Statement from the Heart in 2017, and we know that former Prime Minister Malcolm Turnbull rejected it later in 2017. In 2019, you were asked to oversee a co-design process for a voice to government. Was that a wasted effort, do you think, now that we have a new Labor government and, you know, that they're pushing for a referendum on a voice to parliament?
No, I don't think it was wasted. And if we look at, you know, the voice to government exercise that Marcy and I have led, you only have to read the first 20 pages, and that'll give you of the report will give you a great overview about what's being proposed and the level of support that's out there from our people. So we'll be in the driver's seat on these initiatives. Hopefully, with the new government, that they'll be able to continue to let us lead the process, and they come in and support us through the bureaucrats. We've seen that happening. Co-design is about Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander people working with government on major reforms, but also making sure that we're in the box seat. We're driving the process, being supported by the bureaucrats.
Now moves are being made towards a referendum. Do you support that?
A referendum, that's fine to have it in, as long as we know what the question is in the referendum. My concern is that if we go in not fully prepared, not having the community behind us, if the referendum loses, we lose all opportunity for a voice and all opportunity to be able to develop the work that's been called for by Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander people. So, we've got to, I guess, let it run out. Don't throw the baby out with the bathwater. Recognise that a lot of work's gone. And I think that, some of the pundits would be surprised if they went and canvassed actually other Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander people to find out what their view is, because they'll find out that, there's very mixed views about whether we need to get, something in the Constitution or via referendum, or we just need to put something in place now and work its way up to a referendum. But I think what I've heard from Minister Burney so far is positive, that she's willing to hear all sides before coming to a final position, but also not wanting to rush into it with the potential of losing it. And we've got to be sure, and I think that's the important bit.
Do you feel optimistic for the future of our people?
Oh, look, I do, very much so. You look at all the professions, you look at the university graduates, the professional areas, we're making it. And, having more women in the parliament, and particularly in cabinet roles and front bench roles, can only be good for society, because women will bring a much more compassionate approach. Hopefully they'll be able to influence the way that parties go about their business. And we've got massive youth movements now, on environmental issues, on raising awareness, that's all positive for the future.